And there's a confidence as well that she holds with these clothes, I think, when she comes back. And that's what I noticed when I watched the film. I mean, Odile and I mapped everything out, and it was very much down to her, kind of, you know, where we took us. But I think, you know, the great thing about our whole team was that everyone approached it in a very similar way, and someone described it the other day as quite a delicate film. And I think that even with the progress when it comes to her look, it's all quite delicate and it's all quite gradual. And it's only really when she goes back to Ireland that we see suddenly how much, you know, pop colours she's wearing in her clothes. And she has sunglasses on. And I even remember when I was younger, I wouldn't wear I had a thing about sunglasses where I thought, oh no, that's too flashy. At home, you know, maybe just because the sun doesn't exist at home, we don't need sunglasses. But that's a very confident thing, you know. You need to be able to hold yourself in order to wear those kind of outfits. And so we had mapped that out. And you know, I'm always very drawn to greens and blues, and I always thought that was quite important because it suited me, but also it represented kind of the journey that she had gone on with, you know, I just like the idea of it representing land and water and all that sort of stuff. And so we worked in that way with the colour palette as well. But also what was so lovely, Odile and I loved this, is that, you know, the 50s outfits were so womanly, and it encouraged women, as opposed to now, it encouraged women to have curves and a bum and boobs and all that stuff. And we, you know, girls are so strongly encouraged to be almost waif-like now and not have any shape at all. And at that time, it was healthier, you know. So it was great for all the girls to have, like, proper bras and a big skirt. And, you know, it definitely put you into that that mindset of a woman in the 50s.
I hope you kept that green swimsuit. That's a knockout.
I mean, I wanted it desperately, but
it's going to be an Irish national treasure. It's going to be the new Irish flag, actually.
Who else has got a question? Yes, ma'am.
The Irish flag.
Still damp.
I'll say.